In this video, I need to introduce to you some special matrices that we use all the time in matrix algebra. So the first one is very simple. It's the zero matrix. And that can be m by n, right? General size. How do we write the zero matrix? Like that, zero, okay? So you have to know in the context what is the size of the zero matrix. We don't usually write the whole matrix out. So for instance, if this was 2 by 2, it would just be all zeros, right? So that's an example of the zero matrix. Okay, where does a zero matrix show up? For instance, you could have an equation. So A can be a m by n matrix. And then x can be a column vector, right? M by n. So that means a column vector must be n by 1, right? You have to match the sizes of the matrix. And then if you have, let's work this out. If you have m by n and you have n by 1, then you end up with summing over the middle index, you end up with m by 1. M rows, one column, so that's a column vector. And many times you're solving this equation, so that would be zero. So zero here would be a column vector. Okay, the zero matrix, what else is an important matrix? That's called the identity matrix. So the zero matrix plays the role of zero in the matrix algebra. The identity matrix plays the role of one, right, on multiplication. So this is always a square matrix. So this is n by n. And then when you multiply an n by n matrix by the identity matrix, so say A times I, so we represent the identity matrix by the symbol I, A times I is just A. You just get back the matrix. And that's commutes, so that's also I times A. So you're multiplying square matrices together. All of them are n by n. What type of matrix does that? For the 2 by 2 case, it will be this matrix, 1, 0, 0, 1. Okay? So you can try that out. If you multiply a 2 by 2 matrix by I, you get back the same 2 by 2 matrix. Okay. So these are the most special matrices. There are also names for matrices that arise in matrix algebra that you should be familiar with. One of them is called a diagonal matrix. So let's write down what a diagonal matrix looks like. A diagonal matrix then has only elements on the diagonal and zeros everywhere else. So here's an example of a diagonal matrix. If we do a 3 by 3 matrix, it would be D1 on the diagonal. The diagonal is this middle line that goes through the matrix. So 3 by 3, 0, 0. 0, and then D2, 0, and then 0, 0, and then D3. So that's a diagonal matrix. Whoops, sorry. What other types of matrices? There's a banded matrix. What is a banded matrix? As an example, we can consider a tri-diagonal. Okay, so what would that look like? So banded, it's like a diagonal matrix, but instead of just the main diagonal, it also has elements above the main diagonal and below the main diagonal, but always in this slash type of format. So tri-diagonal means that there are three bands. Tri means three. So for an example here, The tri-diagonal matrix would look something like D1, D2, D3 down the diagonal. And then above the diagonal, we could have an A1 and then an A2. And below the diagonal, we could have a B1 and then a B2. So slash here, slash here, slash there, and then a 0, and then a 0. So everywhere else, there's a 0. So you can imagine a very large matrix. So when you do computations with matrices, you might have, 1,000 by 1,000, and then you would just have these elements going down the middle, one above the diagonal and one below the diagonal. Okay, the other two types of special matrices that I want to tell you about here are the triangular matrices. So we can do the upper triangular matrix. What does an upper triangular matrix look like? So we would have elements only here. If you look at the diagonal matrix, we have elements only above the diagonal, no elements below. So that's why it's called upper triangular. So here we can call that U. So how would it look like if we only have elements above the diagonal? If I use just symbols A, B, C, we would have A, B, C for a 3x3 matrix. And then we would have a 0 here, right? And the diagonal would be D, and then E, and then a 0, 0, and then a F, okay? So this is called upper triangular matrix, right? It's called triangular because if you draw where the elements are, you get a triangle, right? Upper triangular because it's above, it's the diagonal element and above the diagonal element. Okay, and then you can have a lower triangular matrix, so L. You can, obviously, you can see what it is. Let me see if I can squeeze it in here. We have lower, so we have an A, and then a B, and a C, and then a D, E, and F. So then you would have a 0 here, a 0 here, a 0 here. And that would be the lower triangular matrix. And we can draw our triangle here, right? Okay. So these are the special matrices that we'll see later in this course. The 0 matrix shows up all the time, very simple. All the elements are 0. It can be m by n, right? The identity matrix is a square matrix. It has the property that when you multiply a matrix by the identity matrix, you always get the matrix back again. It's this matrix with ones along the diagonals and zero everywhere else. Then you have the diagonal matrix, which has elements only on the diagonal. You have a banded matrix, which shows up frequently in computation, where you have diagonal element and then above the diagonal and below the diagonal. And then you have the upper triangular matrix and the lower triangular matrix, okay? So we'll be seeing these matrices in this course. I'm Jeff Chasnoff. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.